Okay. 3/4 cup. Showed you guys my scoops before. 1 cup. Hot. 2 cups. I'm gonna go ahead and set this up again to remind myself that I'm doing rainbow. Okay, we're gonna turn the sugar on. And set up. I just washed this one from my last batch. I'm gonna set that one up. 3/4 cup. Boop. Ah, shoot. Hang on. Okay, sugar is on. I'm gonna do 30 grams again. This is our second round, so it's another 1.5. Enough. Don't judge. 3/4 cup. Is this for the bloom? Okay, I am going to go ahead and set up for my next batch, which will be 40. Helper bolt is out. It's going to be for one of my colors because I'll be able to dye some of it in the bowl I'm whipping in. I'm going to dye some of it in this bowl. And this is Helper Bowl Junior. Just another little metal bowl. Because rainbow, the portions in rainbow are so small, I can use this bowl to color. And yeah, so they are all ready to go. I have multiple spatulas. I have my calculator. Scale is ready. I've got all of my, these are all of my colors for this. This one I'm gonna build in the order that I want it to be finished in. Sometimes I do it the other way depending on what I'm making. But this one, rainbow, gets built in the order that I want. So I'm gonna do purple, I'm gonna do blue, and I'm gonna do green. I'm gonna talk about food colorings just real quick. These are gel food colorings. You want to use as little as possible. So keep in mind that these are going to change the texture of the marshmallow itself. So this one, rainbow, as beautiful as it is kind of got a little bit more of a sticky texture to it than I would like personally. Yeah, and the colors will intensify over time, so you don't really need a lot. I'm going to use probably about 3 or 4 drops depending on the color for each batch or for each color. Okay, sugar batch 1 is ready. I'm gonna do 11 minutes. I like it a little under whipped. Keep in mind, I am in Central Florida. I have humidity issues. Sugar goes in the bowl. Pot goes in the sink. Spreader guard. Is clean. 3/4 cup. Okay. All right, grab out our sugar. Oh, and look, conveniently, it's already ready. 1 cup. Cups of sugar. Okay, my sugar is almost ready. Salt. It's gonna be like 1.5 tablespoons of vanilla. You can make yours, whatever flavor you want. I'm not gonna get out a half a tablespoon. Okay. Let it fluff back up. Okay, this is the part you're all nervous about. So, let me move my camera half a second. All right. My pupper, the loudest girl in the world. Clean off my whisk. And of course, like any of our batches, you want to work fast. This goes in the sink. And some hands. All right, so start with a zeroed scale. Try this bad boy out. I know because I wrote on here the weight of this one is 1254. So 2416. We're gonna do 2416 minus 1254. 24. 16 minus 1254 equals 1162. I'm going to divide it by 3 because I'm doing 3 colors. 387. Sounds about right. Because I don't weigh my sugar, they're not always the same. I'm going to start with Junior. So 387. Doesn't have to be exact. Set him to the side. Pupper bowl to the rescue! Just make sure you tear it out. To push it all down into the bottom of the bowl. Okay, so next. Let me flip this around. Okay, I have my colors, purple, blue, green. I like to start with, I guess I don't really have a preference. So we're gonna do about 4 drops. I have not found a purple that I really, really like. If anyone has any suggestions, I think the one I have is, and it's violet. Looks a little gray to me. I don't know, it's not terrible, it's just not great. And we've first layer is the hardest to pour because it does not want to spread. And that's why under whipping helps make it a little bit easier. be sprayed. Some of this is just where practice helps. Just having done it a ton of times, you kind of get a feel for how you can manipulate the marshmallow. You want to, like, I don't know if you can see what I'm doing, pushing it down on the edges so that I don't have a big buildup on the wall, so that when I pop it out of the pan, I don't have, like, you know, purple where purple shouldn't be. Take your time with the first layer, because if the first layer is jacked up, the whole thing's going to be jacked up. So you can see it's not perfect, but it looks good. Pepper Bowl Jr. is in the sink. What you kind of want to do is spread it around a little bit as you're pouring it out. So don't just dump it in the center. Because if you dump it in the center, the weight from the marshmallow is going to push the bottom layer out. So you'll have thick edges on the outside, and it'd be kind of thin in the middle. We want to keep it nice and even. Yeah. Same thing. I'm being pretty delicate. I think one thing that I've been working on it with my production assistant is I'm really just touching the surface of the marshmallow and guiding it around where I want it to go. I'm not like bread and butter spreading it, right? Like, this is just sort of smoothing, I guess is a better way of saying it. I mean, it's still a spread, but like really just on the surface of the marshmallow. And kind of gently. This one is a pain in the butt. It did take me a long, long time before I really felt like I had it in hand. And there are, you know, a few things that I learned along the way. And like to spread it out a little bit, or pour it out a little bit. So here we go with green. Same thing. I'm not going to just dump it. Make sure you get all the way into those corners. The first layer, again, that's the tricky one, is just to make sure that it gets all the way into those corners. While I'm smoothing and you're watching, I'll talk about my spatula. It is from the Dollar Tree. Don't discount the Dollar Tree for good equipment. You know, I have probably 15 of these. You know, the most I'm usually, you know, I always have one by my sugar bowl, my pot. That one just kind of lives there. And then I've got a few that sort of linger around. You don't want to have to wash a spatula in the middle of it. And just clean those edges. Keep it nice and smooth. So, there we go. That's our first three layers. Sugar gets turned on. Okay, sugar is ready. Heat goes off. 11 minutes. Boop. That's what she does. There goes in the bowl. Pot goes in the sink. Okay, sugar is almost done. Salt. Something that I may have not mentioned, but that I do, is I have a clean but wet washcloth that kind of lives on the edge of the sink. It doesn't really get used for anything except like wiping off my fingertips, especially when I'm wearing gloves. Just, you know, to keep things clean. But he just hangs out there. Zero out the scale. This one is 1207. Funny how different they are, right? So 2308 minus 1207 equals divided by 3. 367. HPJ, that's Helper Bowl Jr. What am I saying? 367. I'm dyslexic and I have a terrible memory. So, that's what that is. HPJ. Helper Bowl. HPX, Helper Bowl Senior. The first. And this big white ceramic bowl that I use sometimes too. Just depends on what's going on for the day. Scrape it down. keep these little edges clean, so when you're done, just give them a wipe down. Red is kind of a stronger food coloring, so that one I'm going to give three drops to. Oh. Haha, make sure you do it in order. Underwhipped a little bit, it's a lot easier to mix like this. Just making sure I scrape the sides down. And here we go. Now this is set up a little bit, so you can kind of sort of dump it in the center a little bit more. But just as good practice, I do like to just go ahead and spread it out. There's not a good reason to change what I'm doing. I'm not gonna. Clean that up. All right. And spread tight to the corners. Keep those edges clean. I'm going to show you something on this layer since the bottom layer is kind of set. If I get an area that's kind of maybe too thin, right? There's not enough here to cover. You can press down. Sorry. Kind of press down into it, into the marshmallow, and scoop. So see how I'm getting kind of like I'm pulling more out? I'm going to try not to do that, so we want to get a nice even layer, but you can do that without really messing up the layers underneath too bad. Just keep in mind that you just want to scoop the top layer. Normally I would clean off the spatch a little bit more when I do rainbow because you know, I remember pretty quickly to draw. Sorry for moving around, guys. I just want to make sure you get the best angles. So you can see what I'm doing. I'm done smoothing while I'm spreading. It's real gentle. So this is kind of what I was talking about. I kind of blobbed it a little bit in the center. So now I need to kind of move it around. So I've got my spatula a little bit at an angle, and I'm pushing it. I'm just scraping it off the top and moving it to where I need it to be to fill in. These layers are still gonna be nice and even. Or mostly, you know, even enough. I'm sure there's a method to get perfectly even layers. I'm not your guy. Okay. I'm gonna rinse my hands. Okay, last color. HBJ for the win. Use a slightly bigger bowl, but this is what I had. So, yeah. See, this is way less red, food coloring, and a nice color. So, red is going to be the top of my marshmallow. So, I'm going to really just make sure. Yeah, I kind of blocked that out a little bit. Sorry, guys. I'm distracted. Shiny stuff. I'm sure we could. As you get further up into the layers, because there's so much underneath to support it, it becomes less important to do that pre-spread. Anyway. I make a lot of these, but I'm not gonna claim to be an expert. I'm sure you will have your own techniques and methods. I'm sure there are other people who do it differently. But, you know, we wind up with beautiful results. So there you go. That's it. There's the rainbow. This pan doesn't spill because she's heavy. Now, let me go grab one. You can see a finished one. There we go. That's a finished rainbow. So my layers are pretty even. The color looks pretty good. That's a better view. This is an edge one, so you can see how it kind of blended together. But by scraping down the sides, I was able to keep it pretty clean. This guy's left over from the weekend too, so he's been in the heat a little bit. And the colors brighten up a lot then. So anyway, make rainbow. It's a good one. Don't be intimidated by it. What's the worst that can happen? You mess it up, you throw it away, and you start over. Bye, Marshall.